received and filed?
None.
None? Commissioner committee liaison reports, upcoming meetings and events?
You got, leadership tomorrow. Hong Kong trade delegation luncheon. About 30 at Madison's. Oh, I got Sam.
Okay. Yeah, today we got Kiwanis Chili here in delivery. Saturday morning, we're doing the KWAS Christmas program at my store. Sunday is Trinity Lutheran's Chicken and Sausage Dinner. And that's all I got.
And we did have our, RPC annual dinner last night, so I'll have an annual report for you guys. I'll just give it to you on Tuesday. Do that then.
Okay. Okay. Unfinished business, discussion of voting equipment bids?
Good morning. Yeah, we got our bids in, so we're just gonna kind of go over for you guys. They came in pretty good. That's kind of what we thought they would come in as. They're really close. Basically, the difference, I guess, in some of them are that Atkins Company has, you know, they have two separate machines. One machine for the scanner machine, which everybody uses to vote on, and they have the handicap machine separately. So we go back to having two machines with them versus one machine with Elkins. Elkins just has one machine, so we only have one to program, one to take care of, one to store. So the bids are really close. I think there's about $1,000 difference in them.
Yeah, you can see the year one totals there, and I think it's pretty explanatory, but not the green. Yeah, the green is with the new equipment, okay, and then the blue is the used equipment, so you can see the differences there. You can see the 1 year total, and then beneath that is the licensing and stuff beyond that, and then warranty beyond that. So you can see where those land, and then what we know the total would be for years 1 through 10. Steve and I are just kind of kicking around different things. They like the Elkins equipment better. And there's a few points for concern, like the warranty on the Elkins only covers parts. So then we'd also incur all the expenses for any labor. I don't know how common an occurrence that is, but
probably not very much with new equipment.
Yeah. The life of it's approximately 10 years. That's kind of what we had now, right? It's kind of a lot. The big thing that you guys should really know to be able to make a decision on this is the printing costs. Unfortunately, I can't give that to you. We don't know what's going to be, obviously, on the different elections. They, you know, each price it differently, how they come up with their totals. We've gone back and asked, you know, tried to nail it down. It's just proving very difficult. We really are just not able to do that. I did go back to both companies and ask if they would be willing to provide basically the formula that they use to come up with invoicing. The Atkins said that they would do that, and then I think Elkins also will do that. The only difference was that Atkins was willing to cap that at X percent a year. I threw out 3%, and they were agreeable to that. And then Elkins wasn't able to agree to that because they said that they don't know, and I can see that, you know, over 10 years, how much ink and paper and whatnot is going to change. So that's kind of where we're at. We're just trying to figure out what to do, and kind of like to know what you guys are thinking from this initial spreadsheet.
When you say ink and paper, I mean, do we print our own ballots on their paper?
They print.
They print.
And ship.
Yeah, they program and print. We put the election together in our system, our state system, and then we send a file to them, and they put it all together print the ballots and send us the ballots and the test decks and everything. Program our machines basically for the election. So that's the cost that we have no way to contain or control. they sell us the machine, so we ultimately have to use their program, their ballot, buy the ballots from them, so.
So by choosing the equipment, we're essentially being forced into sole source for 10 years or whatever the life of the equipment is. So it's kind of an important number, and there's just really not a way to put, you know, a good value on that to look at a bottom line.
We've been using Elkins, right?
Mm-hmm.
So.
It was a good working relationship.
What has it been costing us to print the ballots? I mean, what was the approximate?
It's all different depending on what's on the ballot, how long the ballot is, how many pages it is, but like our, this would be the April election of this year. It was $25,554.30 was the total bill from them. We ordered 20,425 ballots. We go back last year, the November election. The cost was $39,820. We ordered 37,850 ballots.
And you were saying yesterday how many different kinds, something that may be, you know, an issue on one. So you might have to order a bunch of different styles of the ballots. It's just really an unknown.
It is, because, you know, you take a municipal election, you know, we had 25 different ballot stops. So you have to order 25 different ballot stops. You have to order enough for, you know, the voter turnout you think you're going to have. So
at Atkins, we have no idea.
What we have down here, if you look, the second to last line under that Atkins on the colored ones, that is based off of invoices that they have had for counties of comparable size to Cole County. So that, you know, there's a range, and then I just took the average of that. So that's kind of what they gave us to try to offer some kind of idea. So it's probably in the ballpark-ish. I mean, all you can do is guess, and that's the best guess we have, but we don't know.
It's just frustrating to me. I mean, it's stupid to have 25 different ballots. Totally stupid. Stupid to even print them, period. I mean, to even print a ballot.
Yep, that's the only system's out there right now. So, Mr. Secretary of State, there's a different system. I mean, there's stuff that she can do. We found the captive there, too, on what's approved from the Secretary of State's office.
You're saying Atkins put a cap on it, Elkins won't put a cap on it, or?
Voluntarily. Said they would put a 3% yearly increase on it. Of it properly according to regulations, but they weren't going to give you anything for it, but they would dispose of it. It has to be disposed of properly. So.
So we've had no experience with Atkins, so have we talked to some other counties who utilize them? Or?
I have not talked to anybody. I think that either company would probably be compatible. I just, you know, my opinion is Elkins, I prefer to have the one machine versus the two machines. You know, I only have one machine to take care of there and program. Walk in and check in. We've got new iPads, you know, where you check in at. Scans your voter ID card and just puts you in.
Are you still suggesting Atkins used equipment or new?
I don't know about Atkins.
I mean, no, I'm
I would think I would, we would go with you still. I would, I don't, I talked to Callaway County about that. They said theirs came in, they were in great shape. They only had a problem with one lock on the case, and they fixed it right away. It carries the same warranty, so I would think the used equipment would be fine.
So they've been reconditioned?
No, it's been used one time in a Canadian election. I guess they lease equipment Canadian in Canada, so they give them the equipment, and they use it one time, and it goes back to the warehouse, and it's totally used. Because they only have elections in Canada, I think, every 4 years. Yeah.
Have we ever looked at that, just leasing stuff?
I have not.
I mean, because my concern is that once we buy these, now we're locking in for however long, where we spend money again to, I would think if we're going to spend this kind of dollars over the next 10 years and every other county out there spending the same or more, that, I mean, this is ridiculous. And the taxpayers are putting a big bill there statewide.
Yep.
So something's got to change, and something's got to give. And,
the only way you can control it is to control the cost on the ballot.
Yeah, but if it was all computerized and done electronically with no ballots to print, I mean, you eliminate $600,000 to $1 million over 10 years. That's pretty substantial.
I'm sure even if they figure out a machine that does it, they're still charging for the software, not the printing of the ballot.
Now, you know, we can have 40 people vote in a precinct if we want to. Well, if you, the way you're talking about doing it, you know, somebody, you have to have a device there for them to vote off of. So, you know, that's where it gets expensive to do that. Right now, you just hand a piece of paper, and they go into a booth and vote. So we could have 20 or 40 booths, but we can't have 20 or, you know, iPads for people to go vote on paperless. That's where the cost is.
Here right now, this is just part of doing business.
It is.
It's,
you know, ultimately,
as much it costs, is still part of, it's part of.
It's the cost of doing business.
Yeah.
So in our, we'll have a March election, it's a federal election, so the government will pay for that program. And then we'll have an April election, and the municipalities, we split the cost for them. So the Cole County has to pick up the August and November elections. So it'll cost the county for those two. But like this year, it wouldn't cost the county anything. It was the municipalities paid for it because it was their election, so we divide the costs among them. So, you know, they pay for their ballots and stuff like that once the machines are bought.
If we put something on April ballot, we'll have to pay.
If you put something on it, you have to pay for it, which we don't charge ourselves.
Do we want to wait to table this until Jeff's here? Could we look into leasing? I don't think it's going to be.
I'll ask.
I don't think it's. But I mean.
Well, that's why we're here.
You point out their leases, but they leased them to Canada for one. But I would almost bet you it's.
That was Dominion, the big company did that.
That's not going to be.
Yeah, a local supplier, I don't know if they would do that. Two local vendors, you know. We could ask.
Any other questions you guys have that we can get more information, I'm glad to do that. So just let us know.
So what's our, I mean, if we went with Elkins and we went with used, what's first, I mean, our upfront cost is $80,000, $87,500?
Year one. And then year two and beyond for them would be right under 14 or whatever the 95.68 and the 41.85. That would be our annual cost and then printing cost.
So total years 1 through 10 includes like the maintenance and warranty and everything.
Right, except for remember that the warranty does not include the labor. So add that in. I don't know how much you would actually see of that, but other than that would be the total, yes.
How often did we have to have Elkins redo I mean, did we take them to them, or they come to us, or?
Either way, they have a salesman that lives here, so he would come by and pick them up and take them down, fix them, bring them back. I took them down when I went to the conference because I had to go through Springfield. So I dropped off three there to get fixed of our old ones.
Yeah. What was it, how much was it?
It might be, it depends on what they have to do. They might bill us $100, $300. You know, of course, you know, the labor's not covered, so almost everything's probably going to be labor. They're going to charge me. But with new equipment, I, you know, hopefully it would hold up. You don't know.
We haven't paid a large amount in the last 10 years on these machines for repairs.
Yeah, I don't think there's been any enormous bills that I know about.
And I would bet within the next 10 years we are going to see some changes, because I could, the way everything's going electronic, I could see them coming up with some.
So the warranty part of it is $4,185. The rest of it is licensing.
Okay, let's.
Fortunately, all are on the same.
Yeah, I think so. No problem.
Any other questions you want us to find out from them about anything?
You can just ask about leasing. I'm sure it's not viable. Our other ones last us 10 years. Somewhere. So we try to keep all that separate, like, you know, your city precincts. We have everybody that's voting on those council people voting in that spot. That way we don't have different ballots in different spots. They can't get confused of what they take. And we do that with Eastern and Western District Commissioners, too. You know, they have their ballot here and they have their ballot there. And we try not to overlap them so that everybody gets the right ballot. There's no confusion when you go vote. But there might be folks don't like Jeff and they like Chris, and so they live in Taos.
They
might
have
want
to
vote for Chris.
No. They have to move.
Oh.
There was a lot of that, though. I mean, your precincts don't line up with Eastern and Western District.
They do now. We have.
They do?
Yeah, they were changed. There's no straight dividing line through for that, so. When you get into your county, then they'll have five ballots in a municipal election. They'll have five different ballots, and there's nothing you can do because there's a different fire district, there's different school districts, there's different town of Wardsville. And Florida also have five different ballots. they're talking about is their programming costs. Is there like, how many ballots are you going to have? How many different styles are you going to have? You know, they have to produce 25 different ballot styles with 25 different parts of information. So that's where all your programming costs come in as far as their, that's why they say they can't lock down a price on that, because they don't know how many ballot styles you're going to have. You know, now a lot of the little towns and stuff can vote to not have an election if they have the same amount of people running, like the trustees. Have two positions open and you have two people that, you know, that want to run, well then you don't have to have the election. So that takes them out of that, you know, we won't have to make ballots and stuff for them. So it would lower our costs as far as the ballots go. In that town's, you know, cost. If you don't have any other further questions, then we'll get that answered and try to get on an agenda here in a couple of weeks and bring it back to you.
That'd be great. Thanks.
Thank you all very much.
Can we get these in time for you to do your training?
I think so. The only thing would be they only had like 40 used machines, so if those 40 used ones were gone, then you wouldn't be able to get them anymore. So that's the only, that'd be the only drawback. Now, we don't know. Of course, they tell us there's other counties bidding new equipment too, so we don't know if they're new or used. That's the only thing there, was if that used equipment would be gone, you wouldn't be able to get a hold of it anymore. Initially, I think they said it would take 30 days to get the equipment in. So,
okay.
Wouldn't hurt to wait a couple weeks.
Is that on the agenda for next week? I know we can't make it.
Maybe next week, so maybe the week after. Will you have an agenda this after December 1st? I think there is.
Yeah, I can answer these questions, but I, as far as the discussion, I'll let,
okay, perfect.
You know. I thought you'd be part of that.
Yes, I would.
What are you going to set up for December 1st? Another commission meeting?
No, yeah. No, we already have one set up. We'll just do it before to come back and vote on this.
It's supposed to be a cat reading.
Oh, you are? The second?
That's our.
Budget meetings, then?
Yeah. Can we start that at 8 o'clock?
Yeah.
kind of come back and forth.
Yeah, we know where to find you if we're running ahead. Though.
Yeah, if you're running ahead, come and get me.
Sure.
I have no objections with this.
We hope everyone's
sure, Larry's going to
put it. Oh, it can't be that easy.
No, there's a few coming already.
Okay, accounts payable review.
I asked for approval of accounts payable. Chris, I did move yours to the next one. So
yeah, I denied it.
I mean, denied it.
Send it back to you, Chris.
Okay.
So I'm asking for the 13th and the 16th check run date.
Come back to that.
Okay. Okay. You want to do the second final reading of budget adjustment 13?
Sure. This is for $10,000. This is the $10,000 the law enforcement was going to use for their overtime out of the inmate security file metric. I need action and signing there.
Yeah, there is. There's a transfer, yeah.
Yeah.
I move that we approve court order number 13.
I second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Second final reading of budget adjustment number 14.
Okay, this is the HAVA grant that we were just talking about with the poll book. Total of $36,685.
So I need approval of that. I move that we approve court order number 14.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. First reading of budget adjustment number 15.
This is again what the sheriff came to you guys talked about. For the position and a half in the seal and carry, just from now to the end of the year amounts to what we need to do a court order for, $4,148.97. No action today, but.
Signing of MOU for Sheriff's Department.
Well, this has to do again with the same thing as the position and a half that he's willing to pay for out of his Sheriff's Revolving Fund. So Jill did up a memorandum of understanding from now to the end of the year and kind of has to coincide with that budget transfer. So if we can do it, the Sheriff hasn't signed it yet. Jill did send it to him. So I don't know if you want to wait or go ahead and do it now.
What, how are you doing that for next year?
I went out and you've got the person in the budget for next year.
Right. The people are budgeted in law enforcement fund and then there's a transfer in from the sheriff's revolving fund to cover the cost of those.
So we'll have to sign that again at the end of the.
Yes, you'll have to do a new one for next year for the whole year. And you'll have to do the same thing with our coroner.
Okay.
And the prosecutor. So we'll have three of them again now. We're going on for three.
So how about we just say that he gives us all our money and all his money and we'll spend it how we see fit?
I think that would go over very well.
Thank you. Would really,
sure
all of the taxpayers' money, I should say.
Those tax bills everybody got.
Mm-hmm.
do that.
Okay. The one, they're already hired, just so you know that.
We paid them yet? So he better get that signed before they get paid, so they might be upset when they don't get a paycheck.
Go back to accounts payable.
It's always made to see accounts payable and people start buying tires and all kinds of maintenance right here before the end of the year, so. I did see one in here that we had a tailgate repair on a Dodge Caravan. I didn't hear anything about an accident or anything.
That was at the juvenile center.
Okay.
Yeah. I guess I don't tell you guys about all accidents.
Right.
There was an employee that backed up in the parking lot.
She hit something in the parking lot.
Yep.
Or someone hit something in the parking lot.
And I think it was probably when that construction was going on, the heating.
Something was put where maybe they couldn't see it.
Yep. Definitely our fault, so. Nobody else, sir.
Well, you still got heat over there. I was asking Brad about that. I said, guys, supposed to get cold this weekend. I said, go, do I have heat? He said, oh, yeah, there. I think we're still hooked in the field system right now.
Yeah. I know they're
not.
We may have.
When are they supposed to be done with that?
I see we've paid $22,000 to Civic Plus for the website.
Yes.
And is that all that we owe until they're done?
I have to go back and read that contract. I know I've been asking Melissa if they have performed up until the invoice should be paid, and she said yes, so I'll have to back up the contract.
So Air Systems, you did pay $213,000 of that. Stockman Construction, is that the final payment on Woodward Lake stormwater?
How much was that? I'm not sure that's the final payment.
How much is
that?
$38,000. Eric hadn't come up and had to close out yet on that. And then there's a couple of checks for All Systems, or how are they coming on that?
Jennifer can talk about that.
I was not listening at all.
Access control and
All
Systems. How is the progress, or what have they done, I guess?
So they've done Health Department, they've done Carnegie. I'm going to do the training on Monday with the people at Carnegie, and then myself and Melinda, and then Kevin, we were got in there like yesterday, and they're working on ours over at EMS. They're tracking along pretty good. What specifically did you want to know?
Oh, I just wondered if they were making some progress.
Yep, sure are.
They weren't really in the loop, and we're paying them, so. What all are they putting at EMS? enough. I move that we approve accounts payable.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Do you want to go back? I'm poking you.
Yeah.
Do you want to wait?
Oh, sure. I move that we approve the MOU with the sheriff.
I second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Technology is great.
Listening.
He can hear.
They're all listening.
Yeah, right. Okay, other issues to come before the commission this day?
Since they're all listening, let's tell them all that we're taking away the 4% proposed by the auditor. Just teasing.
Everyone come in the meeting now.
That's kind of like storming the Bastille, boy. Lock the doors quick. I got to push the panic button. Hide underneath the...
We do that though, the panic button may not work.
See, nothing else? Move to adjourn till 4:30, recess till 4:30?